Hello. Hello. Hello, can you see me? Hello, can you see me? If this was good, just give me a thumbs up if this is really good. Good morning, everyone. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Yes, yes, yes. This is a good day. Woo. What's today? Come on, what's today? I need to see them. What's today? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You can see me. Perfect. It's Tuesday. Yes, indeed. It is Tuesday. It's a great day. Oh, yeah. We're gonna be doing our two steps. Let me go play this record. If I can play this record till we get started. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah. Wherever you are, just clap those hands. I believe in having a little fun before we get started. Get everything working out. Good morning, everyone. Come on, we get ready to start sign language class. Just a little music, just to get a little blood flow. All right. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Good morning. I worked the workout this morning. I feel good this morning. Happy Tuesday. Welcome back to American Sign Language class. I hope you had a awesome Memorial Day weekend. I know I did. Hey, I'm still shaking it off. So this is a good day. I'm so happy to see all of you wonderful faces. I have many people popping up. They're still coming on. They're still coming on. They're still coming on. They're still coming on. I'm excited. So good to see you guys. Just a couple of announcements. I just got to share with you a couple of announcements. It's very important. We just have some fun things that we can do. I'm so happy to see you all. So happy to see you all. Our announcements for today, before I get started. Did you send your video yet? If you haven't sent your video of you signing, please send it. The flyer is on the Facebook page. Please send it. You can send it to northpubliclibrary@gmail.com. Please send your sign-in of signing your name. It's just simple saying my name, So my name, and then your finger spell it. I see some people from Delaware. Oh, they popping up. They're everywhere. They popping up. So good to see you guys. They're wonderful people. So you can do that. So it's really, really, really good. Really, really, really good. So you have time. The deadline is Thursday. So Thursday. I have to be right back. I'm sweating. I need a paper towel. So give me a second. I'll be right back. Normally, I'm prepared. I hope you can hear me. So I just need to get me a paper towel. Woo-hoo! That's my dance party move. I said, no, I didn't get a paper towel. I got me a towel. It feels good. It feels good. So, you got the workout. I got my workout on this morning. So, I'm feeling good this morning. Got my sweating, exercising, getting everything to flow. But it's just so good to see all you wonderful people. I just hope that you had a great weekend. And I know it was a three-day weekend. Yesterday we was off and most of us wasn't working. Some people was working. So just want to give you an update. Please send those videos today. I can't wait to see that one. Okay. Y'all just laughing. You're communicating. It's okay. It's gonna be a real cool class today. Also, maybe next week, I'm not sure if it's next week or 2 weeks, I'm going to be doing a question. You can come and join on the live and ask me any question you want. So it's really, really, really good. So you can just join in and ask me questions. Also, in 3 weeks, I'm planning to, you guys can meet the deaf librarian from the North Public Library so we can chat. And we can talk, and you can get to meet the person, the teacher, behind the teacher. She's the teacher. I'm her assistant teacher, so I'm just excited to share that with you today. I'm looking forward today to teach, to share with you wonderful people. It's really, really cool. So we're doing some cool things. Also, just be on a watch out because you never know what may pop up that we're going to be doing. It's going to be really, 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 really cool. I'm excited. It's Tuesday. It's sign language class. Let's just jump right into it. All right, let me just open it up and get started. All right. All right. Since this was Memorial Day weekend, and you know what I mean, some of us had barbecues. It was really, really good. Some of us had barbecue and you guys practiced your social distancing and then you wasn't close to each other. But, I know a lot of us ate food. I mean, ate. So, but I didn't eat that much. Just to let you know, I just ate a little bit. So, but I'm going to just give you some signs. Teach you some signs. It's really cool. Some food signs. We're going to do some food signs this morning. So it won't be bad. So we're going to have some good time and we can talk. All right. So our food signs, this is the sign for food. It's basically eat. So this is our food sign. Basically it's eat. Eat. So we know this is eat. So everybody do this with me. It's eat, so it's really cool, right? All right, so we know we're gonna eat, and this is food, the same exact sign. Eat and food is the same thing. All right, the next one, we're gonna say is cook. So you're gonna take your palm in your hands like this, and then you take the other one on top, and you're gonna flip it up and down. Like you're flipping a burger or a pancake, you flip. This is cook. Who likes to cook? I need to see some lights. Who likes to cook? Just click some likes if you like to cook. I like to cook. I sure do like to cook. If anybody know me, I can cook. Mm-hmm, I can cook. So I love to cook. Do you love to cook? What is your specialty in your cooking? Let me know. So I'm curious to see what you are good at cooking, so I love to cook. That's something that I love to do. Cook. Mm-hmm. You love to cook? We all love to cook, yes. So, cook. So, next one is boiling. So, you take the pop of your hand like this, and you move your four fingers like this. Boiling. Like you boiling some water. Boiling some water. Mm-hmm. Mexican, all right. I like that. Mm-hmm. Especially, what is it for Mexican I like to go? It's a restaurant I like to go and I get it. What is it? Quesadillas. I love quesadillas. Boiling. So, like you're boiling your water. Boiling. Okay? All right. The next one is, we all do this. This is one of my favorite foods that I love. Mash. You take the palm of your hand and you mash it down like you're really mashing something. Like mashed potatoes. I love some mashed potatoes. Oh, whew. I love some mashed potatoes. Ooh, it is really good. So now, I meant to tell you this. Now, this means love. We all know that, right? This means love. But if you really love something, like this is how you would sign it. Like you really love it, like kissing your hand. I love mashed potatoes. Mm. I love mashed potatoes. I really do. I really do. So I really love some mashed potatoes. All right. The next one would be bake. Bake. See, it's, everything is like you on a stove. So you put something in the oven. Bake. 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 With some gravy, yes. With some gravy. This is the sign for gravy, yes. With some sweet potatoes, yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Bake. 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 All right. The next one is stir. Makes sense? It's real easy. Like you're really stirring something. So it's real easy. So cooking stuff is like you are demonstrating it. So you got to show it. All right. So we got cooking. Oh, yeah. Like you're flipping back and forth cooking. Next one is boiling. Boiling. Next one is bake. Bake. The next one is stir. Stir. And after that one, it's slice. It's just like you cutting some carrots, some sliced carrots, I love some carrots. Slice. It's just like this. You take the like a one, like going like the one here, but you put it this way, and you're just doing it like this, slice. Like you're just cutting it up, slice. Slice. Now, it's a difference between slice and chop. This is chop. Make sure you have your hand up this, chop. But slice is going this way. Because you know how, you know, when you go to the deli and they have the slice in it this way and it's just going off just like that? That's the concept. Chop is like on a chopping board and you're just going boop, 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 boop. Chop. Oh, yeah, I love to cook, so you know what? The chopping. Yeah, some chopping. All right. Flip. 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 I know some people was flipping some hamburgers yesterday on the grill. You're flipping, just flipping like, what, take that hand, like you got the spatula in your hand and you just flip it over. Flip. 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 Next one is we're going to do different meats. So this is meat. So take your hand like this, and you put it in there, meat. 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 So we're doing some meat signs. So meat. All right. Next one would be pig. So this is the sign for pig. But when you're talking about meat, this is the animal you do to pig. But you're talking about like you want to eat pork, you finger spell it. P-O-R-K. Sometimes I see people sign pork like this. You know, it's good. It's you know, I've seen that. And some people sign pork like this. You spell it P-O-R-K. The next one is ham. You spell it H-A-M. 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 All right. Next one, everybody. This is an easy sign. Chicken. 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 Is that the sign for dirty? Dirty is moving your head. Pig is doing this. You see the difference? This is the pig, and dirty is this way. So just to let you know, okay? So, chicken. Chicken. I love baked chicken. You see that, how that works? See how that did that? Bake. Bake chicken. I love baked chicken. Chicken looks like 20, yep. But it's close to the mouth, yes. Mm-hmm. So, baked chicken. Baked chicken. I love baked chicken. All right, turkey. The same thing with 20. You just bring it down underneath like a G, a Q under your chin. Turkey, gobble gobble. Turkey. Turkey. All right, we're going to do this again. So we got meat. Meat, it's like here. It's like the thickness of a steak or something, you know, meat. Meat. So it goes just like, it's like the eight clamping over, it's just meat. 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 All right. Then you got pig, as people would say, pork. Or you can say pork, or you can ham, be specific, H-A-M, ham. And then you have chicken. Then you have turkey. And then the next one would be beef. You would finger spell B-E-E-F, beef. Like, for an example, you may ask, like this weekend, you know, it was Memorial Day weekend, and people were cooking out, you know, barbecuing and all of that. And I this is the sign for hamburger, right? I love hamburger. I really do. I like a juicy hamburger. I love hamburgers. And sometimes I ask the person if it's beef or turkey. I love them both. I love them both. The beef and the turkey. So, hamburgers. So, you guys got to do the beef hamburger or turkey hamburger. That's how you would do it. And the next one is my ultimate favorite. I love me some fish. I really do. Fish. It's just like it's going in the water, just moving fish. Fish. Now, if you want to be specific in what kind of fish you like, you will finger spell it. Like, so for an example, salmon. That's my ultimate favorite. S-A-L-M-O-N. Salmon. So you would... Or I like deep blue fish. You know what I mean? So I like that too. Especially when it's like off the grill. Oh, so delicious. I just love me some fish. Okay. All right, we're going to do some fruit. Some fruit. So just to let you know, okay? Here we go. strawberries. You take the ham and you take like a put it on top. Strawberry. I love some strawberry. I really do. Strawberry. Apple. It's like you put an X, put it here. Apple. I love apple. Apple. Next one is watermelon. Water, you pluck water, then you pluck. I don't like watermelon. I'm glad you're here. It's your favorite. I don't like watermelon. I know some of you guys are surprised. Like, all right, this is a story behind why I don't like watermelon. Let me tell the story. All right, give me 2 minutes. I'm gonna tell you 2 minutes about the story. You don't like it either, Martha? Okay, I don't feel bad. I was just saying I don't feel bad. Whew. All right, this is a story behind why I don't like watermelon. Growing up, my family, every year we would go to the South. And my great-grandmother, when she was living, she had a farm in the backyard. So she lived in the country. So when you were a little boy, you had nothing to do. So she said, go outside in the yard and play. So I see these green things over there. I'm like, okay. I start punching it and just breaking it. You know what she did? She whooped my butt. Oh, my God. And I became afraid of watermelon ever since then. I never ate watermelon after that moment. People try to give it to me. I'm like, no, thank you. That's why I don't like watermelon, because I'm petrified of it. So that's the story behind the story why I don't eat watermelon. I don't like it. I'm sorry. So let's get back to class. So it's just a traumatized. Yes, you know, when you're in the South, she's from Alabama. Oh, in the country. Whew. So I was waiting for my cousins to come. It took too long, so she said, go outside and play. So that's what I did. Understand. You understand. Thank you. Thank you for being so passionate. So this is a funny moment. So sometimes good laughter is good for the soul. You know, so you can know a little bit about me. All right. Pear. You spell it P-E-A-R. P-E-A-R. Yes, it was, Celeste. Yes, it was. Pear. All right. Here it is. Grapefruit. So, it's grapefruit. Grapes. This is sign for grapes. So, I love grapes. So it's like the vine, and you just put it in like this, grapefruit. That's how you do grapes, grapefruit. Mm-hmm. And then you have oranges. Ooh, I love some oranges. Oranges. Then you have, this is one of my ultimate favorite, pineapple. So it's really cool. So it's like apple. You see apple sign like this? So take the P and just go like this. Pineapple. Yep, that's how you do it. So do the apple this way, but it's just pineapple. This is how you sign pineapple. Just like that. Let's go back over these fruit signs a little bit, all right? So we got strawberry, which is my ultimate. I like strawberries. Apple, apple, watermelon, pear, P-E-A-R, grapes. What's the difference between apple and cool? I'm going to show you in a second. Grapes, and then grapefruit, and then we have pineapple. All right, what's the difference between cool and apple? Apple is on your cheek, so apple. Cool is on your chin, cool. Apple is on your cheek, cool is on your chin. But sometimes you just be like, I'm cool, y'all. I'm cool. But cool. You're cool. I hope I answered your question. All right? So you got that? All right. The next one, we're going to do some, it's going to be bread. So you're just slicing the bread. I hope this is good for you because we just ate some good food this past weekend because it was a three-day weekend and some people have cookouts and barbecues and all of that. So just to be able to do that. Bread. Orange juice. I'll do that in a second. Just give me a second. I will do that. All right. Someone just asked me orange juice. It is real easy. Juice is J. Just take the J like this. And then put juice. Whatever juice you like. Say, for instance, if it's apple juice. Orange juice. Pineapple juice, grape juice. It's just whatever you associate with it is. Whatever the fruit sign is, and then you do the juice. So you ask me orange juice. Does it make sense? So whatever it's associated with. So orange juice, apple juice. All right? So we could be able to do that. So we have bread. Like you slicing the bread. Mm-hmm. Bread. Next one is nuts. Because it has a shell and it's nuts. So that's how you do that. Someone asked beer and wine. I will get to that in a few when I do beverages. It's going to be coming up in a few minutes. Nuts. Okay. All right. So here we go. Here it is. This is our beverages now. Here it is. Soda. 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 Because it's the soda pop. Soda. Water. Someone asks wine and beer, so I'm going to give it to you. Wine. Wine. Beer. All right, so you got it. Wine. And beer, soda, and water. All right, here it is another one. Coffee, a beverage, coffee. But why? Because the coffee grinds, you get what I'm saying? Coffee. Don't bring it down like this. This is making out. You don't want to sound making out. And I was teaching a few years ago, and one of my students asked me, saying, I want to make out. I said, you want to make out with me? No, you're a student. No, you can't do that. And I said, you want coffee? And I don't drink coffee. Huh? So that's what it is. Coffee, you open it up. Make sure you don't put it down like this. So this was an adult student. This wasn't no youngster. This was an adult student that asked me. So coffee was up like this. So don't bring it down like this. Coffee. I don't drink coffee. I haven't had coffee since I was in college. That was almost many years ago. So I haven't had coffee in a long time, and I don't like coffee. I love tea. See, like you dip in a tea bag. Tea. We know you a good brother. Tea. It's just like you dipping it, and then you dip it in here. Tea. The next one is milk. Milk. Laughing at many years ago. That's a good one. Yes, it is. Milk. This is the sound for milk. So you cover all of that. So those are your beverages like that. And since we are talking about beverages, you know, just give me two like this. Alcohol. So just in case if someone asks me, alcohol. So you know the sign already. Alcohol. All right. So throughout the day, we have our different times where we eat our breakfast, our lunch, and our dinner. So it's really easy. So breakfast or eat in the morning. Breakfast, eat in the morning. What's the difference between brown and beer? Is this time for smoothie? And what about milk? Okay, I will answer those quick questions. Brown comes down this way. Uh-huh. I'll answer that question. What's the sign for green tea? The color green sign, yes. And I'm just trying to make sure I'm brown and beer. Got that. Smoothie and make. All right. So like someone asks for green, you do green tea. Green tea. Green tea. Green tea. I love this tea. It comes from Aspen, Colorado. It's an apple cider tea. And it's really good from Aspen, Colorado. They send it. They shipped it up to me all the time when I order it. It's really good. Really good tea. Smoothie. You finger spell S-M-O-O-T-H-I-E. You finger spell that. And the other one is make. It's just moving it back this way. See, there's a difference between... Like, make it this way, you're making it, going back and forth because you're making it. But, like, you're going around in circles right here, just like a coffee, it's the difference. So, you know that. So, you have, let's continue. Breakfast food. Lunch food. That's lunchtime. And, dinner food. So, you have it that way as well. Toast. Oh, you finger spell it. Is that's how when you know you don't know the words spell. Yeah, that's how it is. It's no sign for it really. You finger spell it. So, but I can teach you some more stuff how we do that as we progress into these classes for the next couple of weeks. And then go from there. Toast. Sandwich, what you do is take your hand like this and you bring it in, sandwich, all right, pancakes, it's just like you flipping something, pancakes, You flipping pancakes. Woohoo. Syrup. You put it right on top. Syrup. French toast. Oh, I love it. French. This is the sign for French. French, and then you put toast. It goes back and forth with the fork from one side to the other. French toast, since we're there. Gravy is just like something that's dripping out of it. Gravy, greasy, oil, it's all in the same sign. Color X pancake and cook is the same sign. Yeah, because pancake, you're flipping it. That's the whole concept. When you're cooking a pancake, you flip it back and forth. All right? Butter is taking your hand out like this. Butter. French fries. It's FF. French fries. I gotta stop right there. Can you tell me who has the best French fries? I just need to know. Is it Wendy's? Is it McDonald's? Is it Burger King? Is it Checkers? Can someone let me know who has the best French fries? I just want to see what the difference is compared. The best French fries. Or if it's your homemade French fries, I take that too. My French fries is really cool. I make some good French fries with the potatoes. Cut them up. Just let me know. Who makes the best French fries out there? So I need to know. I love some disco fries. I don't know if you go down to the shore, you know what I mean. If you go down to the shore to the beach, and like at the boardwalk, they make some disco fries with the gravy, with the mozzarella cheese on it, and French fries. Those are really good. McDonald's, Mine's. I'm with you, like Mine's. Okay. All right. Call out with the potatoes. Okay. Checkers. All right. I just want to see the difference. You know, see what people, homemade fries are the best. Yes. McDonald's, Checkers for you. They must be hot. That is right. You got to have some hot fries. Yes. What's PDQ? PDQ. Well, I don't know what that restaurant is. Nathan's. Oh. I gotta try Nathan's fries. I've never had Nathan's fries. Okay. Smash burgers. Yes, I have that. Yeah. So this is something good. You know, we try French fries. You know what I mean? We're just trying that interaction. Yeah. Tops. Wait a minute. Someone say tops? Oh, yeah. Whoever said tops, I'm with you on tops. I gotta go back. I'm sorry. I'm just so hyped up. You know what? I'm gonna have to go to Tops for lunch today. I don't know. I may have to go to Tops today for lunch. I don't know, y'all. You just gave me something. Whoever just said Tops. But they're coming in. You know what I mean? I may have to go to Tops. Nathan's, okay. I'm gonna try. I'm gonna have to look for a Nathan's spot to be able to get some. All right. So, soup and cereal. I have a way of doing this. Soup, you use this as just for soup. Let's make it easier. Soup, it's in your bowl, soup. Cereal, you take the C, and I do cereal this way. Because it's the difference, because I don't want you guys to get confused with soup and cereal. Because you may be for breakfast, you're going to be getting some soup for breakfast, or do you want some cereal for breakfast? So just to make sure, I got Tops on Friday. All right. Yep. Everybody know Tops. Tops is good. Tops gonna be for lunch for the day. I may have to work it out extra today. Whew, cause I have to like good food. I may work it out today. Tops. I may have to call it in order. All right. So we know this is drink and beverage. So just to let everybody know, drink and beverage. So. All right. Dessert. Yes, the diner food has the best dessert. Speaking of dessert, All right, we're gonna go into dessert. Sweets. Everybody loves tops. Yes, sweets. Sweets and sugar is the same. Sweets and sugar's the same, okay? So, all right. Our desserts are, it's just the way it looks. For an example, pie. What do? Is slice it. Pie. You're slicing it, pie. Cake. What did a cake do? Rise. Cake rise, okay? Cookies. This is cookies. Because you know it's like a circle. Cookies. How do you sign vegan dessert, please? Thank you. I will show you. Okay. Matter of fact, I got a story behind that with vegan. It's really good. All right. Vegan. What you do is you finger spell V-E-G-N dessert. Vegan. So you just go V-G. V-G. You got to do it fast. But it's a process. But slow it out, you do V-E-G-A-N. And you do V-G, dessert. I'm a big food critic. And I had some vegan food a couple weeks ago. It was really delicious. So I'm trying to broaden my horizon in my food. The vegan food option was really good. It was really good. I really enjoyed it. So it's really good. So just to let you know that. All right. So we got pie. We have cake. We have cookie. And this is the other one. Ice cream. It's like an ice cream cone. Ice cream. Now, I'm a big fanatic of ice cream. I am. That's my weakness. Anybody knows me, I have a weakness for chocolate ice cream. Oh, whew, that's my weakness. I'm sorry, I have to admit, I have a weakness for chocolate ice cream. Anybody knows me, chocolate ice cream is my weakness. So, who has the best ice cream? Is it Cold Stone? Dairy Queen? You know what I mean? Just let me know. Mm-hmm. Like vegan goes a long way as with meat. Yep. Mm-hmm. So, yep. So ice cream. All right. Vegetable. Vegetable is like B here. Vegetable. Vegetable. I love me some vegetables. I really do. I'm going to go over some vegetables here with you. So to be known. Briars. I haven't heard that in a long while. Briars ice cream. I guess I'm getting old. My grandmother used to order get Briar's ice cream. Ooh, I'm old. Natado and Ironbound. I got to try that. Thank you for recommending that. I'm going to try that. And Ironbound, Cold Stone. Jordan loves ice cream. Oh, awesome, Jordan. Duncan Hines. Okay, I like that. But Briar's, I'm going to do that. Applegate? Where's Applegate at? Give me some information on Applegate. I like to have some information on Applegate. I'm trying to read up on everybody and interact too. Jenny, your weakness too? Okay. So I'm trying to make this interactive class because we're just talking about food. So we know what it is. Tlatas. Okay, Turkey Hill. Okay, all right, all right. We got some different flavors. Ben and Jerry. I'm not a big fan of Ben and Jerry. It's okay. Breyers is still good. It's in Clifton. Thank you, thank you. I'm gonna have to check it out. I love to travel. I love to travel. Montclair. Okay, all right, thank you. I will look it up. Thank you for the feedback. See, we interact, we get to know each other, what we like and all of that. That's really, really cool. So right now, we're gonna do some vegetables. Some vegetable signing, okay? Here it is. Like, you know what I mean? I love, corn. Corn. Mm-hmm. Corn. Corn. Thanks, Dale. I see you. Corn. Mm-hmm. Corn. So, all right. So, we know this is corn. So, you know what I mean? Corn. So, you eat the corn. All right. Peas. You take it here. You have your hand here. Peas. 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 So we have corn and peas. Peas. Beans. 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 Cooking and cream ice cream. All right. A little different. Beans. All right. Now, this one here, it's a little tricky, but I like to make sure, I like to give the two so I know what's what. You know how you have a head of lettuce and a head of cabbage? I love them both. So when I do cabbage, I do the C, and I put it up on my head like this, cabbage. So that's how you would do cabbage, which I really love some cabbage. I really do cabbage and lettuce for my salad. And I make me some salad and it's real simple. You take the L and I do it on top of my head like this L so I can know the difference of it. Because if you just say I want lettuce or I want cabbage, it may get confusing on what you want. So that's just how you would do that. So so I usually do that for to help you out with that. Lettuce up here. I'm sorry, cabbage right now. I'm signing cabbage. Next one would be lettuce. Lettuce, lettuce, lettuce. And then while we're on lettuce, you know how you have a salad? You toss it. Toss the salad. Like a toss salad, a Caesar salad. And when you do your salad, you will finger spell it if it's like pretending. Like, you know, yesterday was Memorial Day. People may have, watch this, potato. Like you're sticking a fork in it on your potato. Potato salad. Potato salad. Some people may have macaroni salad. So macaroni is normally in like an elbow noodles. So you do macaroni, take the L, the X. Macaroni, and then you bring it in, salad. And like people may go into deeper like it, pasta salad. You finger spell it, P-A-S-T-A, salad. If you having a fruit salad, you do fruit salad. Like if you having a seafood salad, you finger spell seafood salad. You know what I mean? Whatever kind of salad you having. Cobb salad, which is my favorite. I really do. Salad. So, you know what I mean? Salad. So, you know, you do that. So, you got that. So, salad is just tossing. And if you want to add something to whatever kind of salad it is, you finger spell it if you know it. Like, for example, potato, pasta, or macaroni salad. So, you would do that. Or you're going to just finger spell it. Like, Caesar. Like for example, chicken salad, five bean salad. My mom makes the best five bean salad. I'm going to have to ask her to make some for me. So I got to see. I got to see if she would do that for me. So, Mom, if you're watching, I don't know if you're watching, Mom, today. If you could make me five bean salad, I would appreciate it. I love you. I just had to give my mom a shout out. You know, since she makes some good five bean salad. So that's really good on that. All right. So we know this is fruit. We just did that. Fruit. We just went over that. All right. Peaches. Lemon. It's like a bitter flavor. Lemon. All right, let's do it again. So, peaches. Lemon. Like a bitter. Lemon. And then we have grape. Great. All right. And then we have banana. All right. We did all of these. We did all of these food signs. We just have these food signs here. And I'm going to give you your numbers from 30 to 40. Okay. So each week I'm going to give it to you. So ready? 30 is 3-0. 30, 31, 32, 33. All right, my mom just said it. She just said it. She's honest. She said, okay, I want to get my three bean salad. My mom is going to make my three bean salad. All right, my mom is, she just came on. She must have heard me. So, all right, let's do this. 3-0, 39, and 40. Okay? So I'm going to do it one more time. 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40. All right. Levan said, yay for you, enjoy your salad. Can you make some for me? Mom's okay. Awesome. My mom is a retired dietitian after 39 years serving the Jersey City public school system. 39 years. That's a long time. She's been serving the children, so she's a state certified, so, you know, she cooks, she's a food inspector and all of that. She has her expertise, and I thank you. So, it's the end. I'm so sorry. It's the end of class. Oh, I don't want it to leave. It came back so quick. But I just have a few more announcements. Did you fill out your census? Come on. I need you to fill it out. I need you to share with your friend. Tell somebody. Fill it out. You can contact the census and they can help you. We need to get our numbers up. Our numbers are low. So it's important that we get our numbers up and share about the census. It's very important. Can you do me a favor? Fill out. I did mine. I tell everybody, please fill it out. And this week, I even helped some people fill it out on their phone because they didn't have the paper. I helped them fill it out on the phone. Just simply saying, hey, go to this app, and they did it. So it really did. So it's really good to do that just to be helpful. Do me a favor. this week, please send me your videos. I need to see your videos. Someone say, will do today. Thank you. Please do. We want to make sure everyone's counted. Send your videos today to the North Public Library. The flyers up on the Facebook page. You can send it up that way. It's real quick. You write us real quick. It takes like 5 minutes to fill it out real quick. And send those videos. And also, I want to hear your testimony. You don't have to sign your testimonials. You just get to say how the class has helped you. If you are a nurse, if you are a police officer, and it's helping you during this pandemic. So it's very helpful on that to be able to do that. So it's very crucial to do that. So just look out for that. It's Tuesday. What it is? It's Tuesday. Come on, y'all. Let's do the two-step Tuesday. Come on now. I'm doing my little two-step Tuesday. So I'm so happy that you join us today. Today is a great day to make it a great day. Do something special. Have some fun. Go outside. Get some of that vitamin D. Wear your mask. Wear your gloves. Be safe. Practice social distancing. I'm doing that. I'm ready to get back on to my workout on. I got my workout gear on, so I'm going to give me a little run in for this afternoon. I'm going to get my jogging. Got to stay fit. All that food I ate this weekend, I got to lose it. So I may even do some stairs today. That's my goal. I may do some stairs today, so this afternoon. So do something fun. Next week, we may be at a different location. I don't know. Just wait and see. I hope to see you next week. Let's do the two-step suit that, to the right. To the left. Back it up. That's line dancing music. So we talk about that later. You guys have an amazing day. Thank you for joining. Your information will be posted up momentarily, what you have learned today. Okay, thank you. I love you guys. Be safe. See you till next week. Thanks to the North Public Library for hosting a great, great session today. Thank you. Love you guys.